don't worry, I won't do that for the whole vlog. But you're gonna have to get used to it if you wanna go see The Artist. In theaters right now, The Artist is a full-length silent film. It takes place in the 1920s, when silent films were still the norm. The story follows George Valentin, a famous silent movie star. However, when the rapid transition to talkies begins, George and his dog are quickly abandoned along with their silent films. Meanwhile, up-and-coming talkie star, Pepe Miller, takes an interest in George. It really is a silent film. There are a few text boxes with subtitles, but not that many. Sometimes there is only one during an entire conversation. You have to pick up the rest of what is being said from the context, body language, and the movement of the actor's lips. I can see how that might be frustrating for some audiences, but if you're willing to experiment and try something new, you won't be bothered by it. I was really intrigued by the lack of sound before I started watching the movie. I figured that halfway through I'd get used to it and stop thinking about it. That never happened. I wasn't disturbed by the lack of sound, but I was constantly aware of it. It makes you think that the movies today are a little bit extravagant with all their dialogue. You really don't need all that much to get the point across. But then again, I don't think these vlogs would be very good if there wasn't any sound. What do you think? Could I be a 1920s movie star? The Artist has some beautiful music that plays throughout the entire film. It really supports the film. The movie is made in the style of 1920s movies. I wonder what a 1927 movie audience would say. Would anything stand out as odd to them? Much of the movie is very melodramatic. The actors' performances are over the top, their reactions exaggerated, and their facial expressions are a little bit unnatural at times. But they have to be, because there are no words. Without this, the movie would seem incredibly dull. Again, this might annoy you if you focus on it, but it is a genuine aspect of the silent era genre. My main criticism is that I thought the film began rushing towards the end. The movie had a great plot and really interesting character development, so the filmmakers really earned themselves the right for a more drawn-out ending. But unfortunately, they didn't take that opportunity. However, the story is still very touching. The romance was beautifully portrayed, and there are a couple twists you will not be expecting. In many ways, it's like a silent version of Singing in the Rain, but with a couple more serious turns. One of the biggest things going for this movie is that it is unique. It's a breath of fresh air. The film is pretty self-selecting. If you're watching this and thinking, I think I'd really like The Artist, you probably will. Also, I just wanted to make sure everyone knows that the Golden Globes will be airing this Sunday. The Artist is actually nominated in quite a few categories, along with other great films such as The Help, Hugo, and War Horse. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to like Toast Wallet on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, and have a fantastic day.